We want to find the sum using base 10 blocks and also write the sum in expanded form. We have 2n58 hundredths plus 1n97 hundredths. Because we're working with decimals, we'll define a flat as one whole, a long as 1/10, and a bit as 1/100. So for 2n58 hundredths, we have 2 flats for 2 whole, 5 longs for 5/10, and 8 bits for 8 hundredths. For 1n97 hundredths, we have 1 flat for 1 whole, 9 longs for 9/10, and 7 bits for 7 hundredths. Because we're adding, we want to combine all the base 10 blocks to find the sum. So let's go ahead and move all the blocks down to the bottom. And now let's find the sum. Let's first take a look at the hundredths. Remember, 10 hundredths is equal to 1/10, or we can say 10 bits is equal to 1 long. And we have a total of 15 bits here, or 15 hundredths, so we'll make an exchange. We'll take 10 bits, or 10 hundredths, and exchange it for 1 long, or 1/10. So move this long over to the tenths place value. Notice now we have a total of 5 bits in the hundredths place value, or 5 hundredths. But now we have a total of 15 longs in the tenths place value, and we know 10/10 is equal to 1, or 10 longs are equal to 1 flat. So now we'll perform another exchange. Again, we'll exchange 10 longs for 1 flat. We'll move this flat over to the ones place value. Now we have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 longs, or 5/10. Looking at the ones place value, we have 4 flats, so we have 4 ones. So our sum is 4 plus 5/10 plus 5 hundredths, or 4n55 hundredths. So again, our sum is 4n55 hundredths, or 4.55. But to write this in expanded form, this connects more directly to what we found using our base 10 blocks. Going back to our blocks again, 4n55 hundredths is equal to 4 plus 5/10 plus 5 hundredths. So that would be the expanded form, 4 plus 5/10 plus 5 hundredths. I hope you found this helpful.